Hello and welcome to the channel. In this video I'm going to be fitting an LED light bar to my Honda CT110, and as usual, if that's something you're interested in, stick around and I'll get straight into it. Now, this is the LED light bar that I bought from the Big C. I didn't show you me removing everything from the box. I didn't want to waste your time. There are two handlebar mounts. I won't be using those. I'll be mounting it just above, either above or below the headlamp. Also, no instructions, so it should be simple, right? Well, no, not really. And all the threads are awful. They will need re-tapping. Can't screw the bolts in. Also, the two bolts, M5 and M6, the spring washers are M5, so they don't fit on the larger bolts. I'll have to make some brackets myself to bolt the light bar onto the top of the headlamp. Should be simple, correct? Well, we've got a switch and the light bar. Plug and play, right? Well, no, not really. It's the only place where this switch can go. So I tested the continuity with my multimeter, and what should happen is this would be connected to the battery, positive and negative, with an inline fuse, and then simply connect these two together. But if you have a look, we've got two male connectors. Thank you. So that will have to be changed. But I'm not going to use this wire down to the battery. I'm going to use the power feed, which is a black wire, normally powering the front brake light switch. I'll take a power feed from that and then simply connect the ground to one of the greens, one of the earth wires. Hopefully that will work. I just need to make a couple of small brackets. Fingers crossed. Let's see how we get on. Well, I have finished fitting the light bar. I think it looks not too bad. Let's get a bit closer and I'll explain exactly what I did. Well, if you've seen my other videos, you'll know that this bike was originally a 6 volt, but it's been converted to 12 volt electric. So this is a 12 volt LED light. I'll try and talk quickly. My neighbour will get his angle grinder out, no doubt. And I bought one that's, it's more or less 6.5 inches wide, 165mm, more or less the same width as the headlight. The brackets supplied with the kit, obviously I couldn't use them because I wasn't going to mount it to a handlebar, so I just simply made it two brackets from some plate that I had lying around. Easy to make. The wiring, a bit of a mess around, but not too difficult. And what I did, the kit comes with two wires, a red and a black wire that should go down to a battery and go direct to the battery. I didn't want to do that. I wanted this so that when the ignition was turned off, there was no power to the LED light. And to achieve that, what I did, I used the power source to the front brake light, which is a black wire inside the headlamp shell, and I fitted that to the positive side of the LED light. And then for the negative, if you connect the negative side of the LED through to the negative side of the front brake light switch, what will happen when you press the brake light for the rear brake light, the LED light will go out. And for the negative, what I did, I ran a wire down and bolted it to the horn mount there. It is a little bit confusing with the wiring because Honda wiring, black is the positive power source and green is the ground or earth, whereas with the kit it's red for positive and black for negative. A little bit of head scratching, it's not too difficult, and it works out well in the end. And so the switch is mounted on the handlebars there, so with the ignition turned on, press the switch and away we go. Let's see how it looks. So with the ignition turned on, I'll press the switch. There we go, job done. This is really handy if you get caught out at night. Obviously the standard headlight is not too great, even a 12 volt light is not too great. Hopefully this will be a good addition for seeing where I'm going and also other people seeing me as well. Easy to do, cheap to buy, and a worthwhile addition to your little postie bike. Thanks for watching, thanks for all the subscribers, and I'll see you again soon in the next video.